So, you led like memorable hits of Slaves, Just a Touch of Love, Watching You, Wait for Me, and Snapshot. So, come 1981, 82, is there a point when you realize that it's time to spread your wings and move on?
Well, the first thing that happened, if you notice after the first Slave album, right?
Right.
There was people coming and going. The lineup always changed. The cool thing about it for a while is the lineup changes, the group evolved and continued to get better.
Right.
But then at the same time, though, Stevie Washington, who was the leader of the group, Starlita Young, who also sang vocals on Just Freak and other joints, and Kurt Jones, they felt uncomfortable with how some things were going from the business point of view. They left the group right after the Stone Gem album. They didn't tour with us. And they started Aura, which Aura was first an offshoot of Slave when we were all together, their first album. But their second album, they had on their own as Aura group, not having nothing to do with Slave. That was the first chink in the armor, crack in the wall, if you will. That was a big deal because he was the leader of the group and the visionary. So the great Mark Adams, the bassist, became the leader of the group. And Stevie asked me, did I want to join with them? And I said, no, I'm going to stay with the brothers band from Dayton. So we went on to do the Showtime album. And we were very proud of that record. But a lot of the issues that was going on that Steve saw and was uncomfortable with, and it's been a part of Black entertainment since the beginning, where there was just business issues. That being said, I decided to go ahead and leave after the Showtime album to do Steve Arrington's Hall of Fame. And we remained friends throughout all of that. And there was never really some bitter breakup. It's just we all knew, and they had issues as well with what was going on. But see, I was never actually signed to the group. So I was singing lead vocalist a lot of the times, and also, one of the primary writers, but I never was signed to the group. So I was always a side man. That being said, I just said, well, okay, things are going a certain way. I'll just go ahead and start my own unit. And that was Steve Arrington's Hall of Fame, with the first single being Way Out.